So welcome to the course of flexible AC transmission system. In the last class we started this unit 5 that discuss about the various advantages of series compensators. Now today we are going to discuss about the second concept which is mentioned in our syllabus, that is the concept of series compensation. So let us assume the two machine system from generation end to this one. Let us the two machine system, it have offering V delta and this offering V zero, because of I am taking as this is generation, this is the receiving end, that is the two machines, and V delta and V zero, and we know that in between the say generation V delta to the V zero, it having the transmission line offering some impedance. Especially in the long transmission line, the impedance Z is equal to always X only. We not consider the reactance, therefore X, but in the concept of this series compensation, X can be divided into two parts. It can be divided into two parts, that is X by 2 and X by 2, instead of taking X. And the purpose of dividing these X by 2 is into chestamante ekram. Suppose any fault current occurs. If it is one reactance failed, the another reactance will limit that fault current. That is the main purpose of dividing the reactance into two half of the parts. That is the main purpose. If there is any short circuit in this reactance, then one reactance will be short. Adhe manaku okatanni two divide chesukunnappudu manaki by chance ikkada reactance lo problem inko reactance lo problem raadaniki chances takkuvunte. That's why we are dividing the total reactance of the transmission system into two half of the parts, inductive reactance X by 2 and X by 2. But with the help of the series compensator, we are adding some capacitance XC. So, XC in what money in the aspect divided two parts, XC by 2 and XC by 2. Total X is divided into XL, XC. XC in one add just now, then XC by 2 and XB 2 in add just now. XL in just X by 2 and X by 2. It already exists in the transmission system, exists in impedance. మనం యాడ్ చేసింది ఎక్స్ బై టూ ఎక్స్ బై టూ ఎందుకంటే మన సిరీస్ కంపల్సర్ కాన్సెప్ట్ కాబట్టి ఎక్స్ట్రా రియాక్టెన్స్ ని యాడ్ చేస్తున్నాం అండ్ ద కరెంట్ ఫ్లోయింగ్ త్రూ దిస్ వన్ ఇండక్టివ్ రియాక్టెన్స్ ఇస్ ఐ అండ్ ద మిడ్ పాయింట్ ఆఫ్ ది వోల్టేజ్ ఇస్ విఎం సో ఇట్ ఇస్ లుక్స్ లైక్ అవర్ మిడ్ పాయింట్ వోల్టేజ్ రెగ్యులేషన్ ఆఫ్ ది అవర్ షంట్ కంపెన్సేషన్ చోట్ల మిడ్ పాయింట్ వోల్టేజ్ రెగ్యులేషన్ చేసాం ఏం చేస్తాం జస్ట్ అన్ని వోల్టేజెస్ లెట్ అస్ అస్యూమ్ దట్ ఆల్ ది వోల్టేజెస్ అవైలబుల్ వి డెల్టా అండ్ వి జీరో అండ్ all these are equal to same voltage, that is 1 per unit and assume this. So here also assume that V delta V or Vm all are equal voltages, we assume that. And also we draw the phasor diagram for this one. So before going to the phasor diagram, what is the X value? XL minus XC. What is XL? Take XL comma 1 minus XC by XL. What is XC by XL? 1 minus k, where k is the degree of series compensation. And also I am notice that very important point on the note chest, kxl is equal to 1 minus k, where k is the degree of series compensation. The k value should be in the economical one. Generally k value is in between 40% to 75%. K value generally 40% to 70%. 0.4 nunchi 0.7 value untundi. This is the economical for series compensation, very important. So from k value should be lies in between 40% to 70%, the k range. So therefore, where xl is present, then x can be replaced with, total reactance can be replaced with xl into 1 minus k. Is it clear? So notice this equation in the upcoming calculations. Note that this is the equation 1 now. And also assume that all the voltages are equal. And it is a two machine system. And also we know that from phasor diagram, Vs and V are sending end. Some this is the receiving end. This is the phasor diagram. So this is Vs and this is Vr. Already this diagram ela draw chela manaki midpoint compensation lo cheppanu Vs V0 V receiving end and the midpoint having the voltage capital Vm. The current flowing through this one is capital I. And the drop in between the the angle existing between Vs and Vr is delta. Vs and Vr is angle existing is delta. This angle is delta by 2. This angle is delta by 2. So total angle delta it is delta by 2 and delta by 2. This is Vm. And the drop in between sending end to midpoint is this drop. Therefore, only if if you not consider any capacitance effect here, J by X by 2 into capital I. Similarly, JX by 2 into capital I. But the total reactance voltage across the reactance is each one having Vx by 2. ఇక్కడ నుంచి ఇక్కడ ఉన్న రియాక్టెన్స్ వోల్టేజ్ విఎక్స్ బై టూ అవుతుంది, ఇక్కడ నుంచి ఇక్కడ విఎక్స్ బై టూ అవుతుంది. సో హియర్ టు హియర్ విఎక్స్ బై టూ, హియర్ టు హియర్ విఎక్స్ బై టూ. దేర్ఫోర్ టోటల్ రియాక్టెన్స్ వోల్టేజ్, టోటల్ రియాక్టెన్స్ వోల్టేజ్ అక్రాస్ దిస్ రియాక్టెన్స్ ఈస్ టూ విఎక్స్ బై టూ, టూ విఎక్స్ బై టూ, విఎక్స్ బై టూ ప్లస్ విఎక్స్ బై టూ. టోటల్ రియాక్టెన్స్ అక్రాస్ దిస్ వోల్టేజ్ ఈస్ 2Vx by 2. Is it clear? But here we are adding one capacitance in series with this line. But this capacitance flows, capacitance will current flow. But the drop across this capacitance, which is opposite to the normal transmission line reactance voltage, Vx ki, transmission line reactance voltage and Vx ki, ekkadunna voltage opposite lo untundi because of this capacitance effect. Therefore, it is like look like this one. Therefore, it happens. What is this value? J into XC by 2 into I minus J. Here also minus J by XC by 2 into I. Because of the reactance drop and voltage, reactance drop of this capacitance and the reactance drop of, voltage drop across this capacitance and voltage drop across this reactance, both are opposite because of XC has the polarity minus and the X by 2 having the polarity negative current, positive current. Because of negative current and positive current, both voltages are in opposite directions. So minus J into XC by 2 into I, here minus J into XC by 2 into I, but here this is plus plus. This is the total Vx changes. So this is about the main phasor diagram of this machine system. So is it clear out? Now we want to further calculations for this concept of series capacitance. What is the real power flowing? What is the reactive power flowing? So first the equation is x is equal to xl into 1 minus k, that is equation 1. And next, to derive the expression for the real power flow and real power flow and reactive power flow for sending end and receiving end in the both the ends, I want to derive this PSN QS. So we know that what is the current I? Vs into delta minus V0 by XL into 1 minus K. This is the I value. From this phasor diagram, we can observe that it is a phasor diagram. I think we got 2V by X into 1 minus K into sin delta by 2. I am getting directly because of where phasor diagram is sending into midpoint along the angle is sin delta by 2, then from that we get 2V by X into 1 minus K. This is the I current. But I want the sending end real power and receiving end real power, sending end real power PS and sending end reactive power QS. We can replace with VS into I conjugate. VS is nothing but VS delta into I conjugate is VS delta minus V0 by XL into 1 minus K whole conjugate. Taking real powers terms and imaginary terms here, we got PS and QS directly. Ikkada dantlo chi real power terms, reactive power terms, vidiga teeskunte, we can get the PS and QS. So here, the PS value is, V square into sin delta by X into 1 minus K. Whenever this degree of series compensation K is added, V square into sin delta by 2. And similarly, QS is equal to V square into 1 minus cos delta by X into 1 minus K. V square into 1 minus cos delta by X into 1 minus K. For sending end real power and sending end reactive power. Similarly, you have to do the calculations from the receiving end side also. This is the sending end real power and reactive power. Similarly, receiving end reactive power. From receiving end, QR plus JQR is equal to V are receiving and voltage into current because of sending and current and receiving and current all are in series in two machine system here. And they got a series low on nine. Inductance, reactance, load, generation, only series low on nine cover T. Sending and current and receiving and current octave line low on the cover T. Therefore, IS conjugate is nothing but VR conjugate. IR conjugate out in the. Therefore, VR in the market, VR at the rate of angle and the receiving and side VR at the angle zero into IS conjugate. What is the ending and current? VR into Vs delta minus V of 0 by x into 1 minus k conjugate. This is the equation. We are similarly taking real part one side and real imaginary part one side. Taking real part one side, we got PR and one side imaginary part, we get reactive power QR. PR plus JQR. So PR, from this equation, PR is equal to V square into sine delta by X into 1 minus K. Because of all the voltage sending and receiving and midpoint for all the vehicles, same. Therefore, PS, PR are same. V square into sine delta by X into 1 minus K. Similarly, QR is equal to V square into 1 minus cos delta by X into 1 minus K. X into 1 minus K. Is it clear? So PR and QR. From this observation, you can conclude that PS and PR and QS and QR are the same. If you are assuming that all the voltages are equal and neglect the losses. And also, you can derive the expression for the reactive power generated by the particular capacitor. While adding the capacitor, reactive power generated by this capacitor is I is equal to Q is equal to I square into XC. This is the reactive power generated by this series capacitor. Q is equal to I square into XC. What is I here? What is I? 2V by X into 1 minus K into sine delta by 2 into what is XC? So this is I value. 2V by X into 1 minus K sine delta by 2 into XC. We know that K is equal to XC by X. From this, what is XC? K into X. Where X is the series capacitance, K is the degree of series compensation, X is the reactance of the inductive reactance of the transmission line. So from this simplicity we can further calculations because of I is 2V by X into 1 minus K sin delta, but I square is there, therefore put square root them, square change then 2V by X, therefore 2 square root them 4V square by X into 1 minus K whole square. X into 1 minus k whole square into sine square delta by 2 into what is xc? Xc can be replaced with k into x. What is xc? Xc can be replaced with k into x. 4v square by x by x into 1 minus k whole square into sine square delta by 2. We know that what is the sine square theta formula? 1 minus cos 2 theta by 2. Then we get further simplify them. Simplify చేస్తే ఏమొస్తుంది ఫ్రమ్ దిస్ కాన్సెప్ట్ 4v స్క్వేర్ బై x ఇంటూ 1 మైనస్ k హోల్ స్క్వేర్ ఇంటూ వాట్ ఇస్ sin స్క్వేర్ డెల్టా బై 2 1 మైనస్ cos డెల్టా బై 2 దట్ మీన్స్ 1 మైనస్ cos 2 డెల్టా బై 2 బై 2 ఇంటూ వాట్ ఇస్ హియర్ kx kx మల్టిప్లై బై kx, but here 2 and 4 are cancelled, therefore we got 2v square by x square and x square into 1 minus k whole square into what is here there 1 minus cos delta 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 by 2 delta by 2 to cancel, then 1 minus cos delta by kx and we cut into one by card. So here I am drawing very Here this is 2 and 4 are cancelled, then 2v square by x square into 1 minus k whole square into 1 minus cos delta into what is here k into x. Here x is there, here x square is there. For 1 x is cancelled, then 2v square by x into 1 minus k whole square into 1 minus cos delta This is the final expression for the reactive power generated by the capacitor 2 is equal to 1 minus k square root into 1 minus delta. So this is about the concept of series compensation. In the next class, we are going to see the different types of series controllers. Thank you.